Hello and welcome to my class. To continue with the first theme of class 11th history, till so that is the from the beginning of the time till so far I have discussed about the primates, hominoids, hominids. Then we have discussed about Australopithecus. We have discussed about the positive feedback mechanism and about the homos, right? So these things we have already discussed in the previous videos. Now in this video I will be focusing more on homo, right? So let's start the topic. Homo is a Latin word which means man, right? Comparatively much advanced species than Australopithecus. Now fossils of Homo habilis, and we have also discussed about that homos were categorized, the species of homos were categorized into three categories: Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Homo sapiens, right? And the fossils of Homo habilis discovered at Omo in Ethiopia and Olduvai Gorge in Tanzania. These were the places from where the fossils of Homo habilis have been discovered. Now Homo erectus, their fossils are found in Africa and Asia. Now in founding fossils in two different continents, it indicates that there was migration taking place from one place to another, right? Probably they migrated from Africa to, from Eastern Africa to the Western Asia, right? And they, it is believed that they survived for 1 million years, right? A very large time span. Then some of these species, they derived their names from where their fossils have been found, from the places from where their fossils have been found, right? For example, Heidelberg is a city in Germany. So the fossils that are found here, they are termed as Heidelbergensis, right? And Neanderthal, after the place called Neander Valley, right? And these two the fossils that are found in Neander Valley and in Heidelberg, these are the fossils of the early fossils of Homo sapiens in Europe, right? They were distributed, these Homo habilis were distributed in Asia, Africa and Europe. So it shows that they were having this movement from one place to another. They were migrating in three different continents. Now Homos, as compared to Australopithecus, they were having a larger brain, right, which indicates that they have more intelligence, better memory, better thinking capacity they were having as compared to the previous species like Australopithecus, right? And their jaws with a reduced outward protrusion, which means that one image is given in the in your book, so showing skulls of different species of human ancestors, right? So it shows that how the jaw size reduced earlier. In case of Australopithecus, the jaw was much more outward, having outward protrusion, whereas in case of Homos, this outward protrusion is comparatively less, right? Then they have smaller teeth. In case of Australopithecus, large teeth were there. Now in case of Homos, the teeth size reduced and they are comparatively smaller in size. So these were the bodily changes that were taking place, right? And these the changes in the jaws and teeth indicate that probably there was a change in their dietary habits, right? So these were the changes of how a species is adapting to its natural environment. Accordingly, the body, their body, the changes are occurring in their bodies, right? So all these factors are indicating towards that only, right? So we, this is all about the homos. Please like, share and review, and please subscribe my channel. Thank you.